museum's libraries, archives, and family collections, and it's hoping that it will be a significant digital legacy for future generations. Diane Lees, French General of IWM, said the Imperial War Museum was established while the First War was still being fought to ensure that future generations would understand the causes and consequences of war. Sounds fantastic, doesn't it? Because I bet there'll be some stories, and I bet there will be things. This website goes live later this year, in time for the start of centenary commemorations for the summer of 2014. And in fact, further information, including a short film about the lives of the First World War, can now be found at www.livesoftheFirstWorldWar.org. www.livesoftheFirstWorldWar.org. Quarter to six. You said hi to a Dan Whitehead.
The man who submitted murdering 12-year-old Tia Sharp in South London last summer could face 30 years in jail this morning. David Cameron will today publish a draft bill aimed at writing into law his commitment for an in-out EU referendum by the end of 2017. The thieves have used a stolen car to ram into a jewellery shop in Holloway this morning. And look at London's weather, some sunny spells but clouding over, but some heavier showers this afternoon. There are highs of 11. This is LBC 97.3. And in the LBC 97.3 traffic centre, Andrew Corbin. Still issues on the M25, Andy, in Hertfordshire?
Yes, at least DBS, a clockwise carriage way into junction 21. The link to the M1 going north, perhaps going up towards Hemel Hempstead or Luton. You can't at the meantime because it's shut. It's after lorry return. There's a spillage of diesel as well. Now, recovery teams are there, but because the lorry had to be emptied and have its contents transferred to another lorry, it's going to take a bit of time. Yes, so diversion in the meantime via the junction 21A, south on the 405 to join the M1 at junction 6. It could drag on throughout the morning, I suspect. We'll keep an eye on that one for you. Seven Sisters Road to Holloway.